that all the major themes were created for Twin Peaks. It's an old Fender Rhodes and kind of beat up. And David would sit right over here, right to the right of me, and we would put a little cassette just about over here on this keyboard, just keep it in record and just keep it playing. David would sit here and I'd say, well, what do you see, David? What is, just talk to me. And David would say, okay, Angelo, we're in a dark woods now. And there's a soft wind blowing through some sycamore trees. And there's a moon out and there's some animal sounds in the background. And you can hear the hoot of an owl. And you're in the dark woods, you know, just get me into that beautiful darkness with the soft wind. And I started playing. And David would say, Angelo, that's great. I love that. That's a good mood. But can you play it slower? And I'd say, slower, David? Okay. And I'd go, he says, that's it. That's a good tempo. Just keep it going slow like that. Just keep that going for a while. And in David's mind, you can just see that he was visualizing the description that he envisioned. Then he would say, okay, Angelo, now we got to make a change, because from behind a tree in the back of the woods, there's this very lonely girl. Her name is Laura Palmer, and it's very sad, but get something that matches her. And I just segued into this. And he'd say, oh, that's it. It's very beautiful. I could see her. And she's walking towards the camera and she's coming closer. Just keep building it. Just keep building it. And she's getting close. Now reach some kind of climax. And I would go, and he said, oh, that's it. Oh, that's so beautiful. Angelo, oh, that's tearing my heart out. I love that. Just keep that going. Now she's starting to leave. So fall down. Keep falling. Keep falling. Keep falling. Now go back into. David got up, he gave me a big hug. He said, Angelo, that's Twin Peaks.
We are living in a time obsessed with actuality. People like immediacy, haste, and actuality. And poetry is timeless. This means that it doesn't correspond to what's happening. It is out of the moment. Poets have an extraordinary method. I already told you that poetry is a kind of superior mathematics, a supreme language. But at the moment, we are experiencing something very dangerous, collective genius. Science is made up of collective genius. It consists of men who unite to do extraordinary things, to achieve marvels like the electronic brain. While the real man of genius, the poet, and the poet in all his forms is alone. Oh. genius hasn't become something like a shameful and contagious sickness against which you wish to be immunized. That the individual and the individual genius doesn't count anymore and are replaced by a great collective and scientific genius. Many people think that one can stick to old-fashioned politics. Other people look too far ahead and lose all sense of reality. It's likely that our politics of today seem completely incomprehensible to you, since they already seem that way to us. There is a secret diplomacy, a secret war, undertaken by mysterious agents. Oh.
Thank you. Yeah. Understanding. When you look out, a golf ball size awareness, and when you wake up in the morning, a golf ball size wakefulness. But if you could expand that consciousness, then you read the book, more understanding. You look out, more awareness, and when you wake up, more wakefulness. 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 Wakefulness.
Kinschmidt à Kulchwe. Also, da kommt